Hello and welcome to the Vector Garden YouTube channel. I'm going to take a look at the new text to vector graphic function in Adobe Illustrator version 2024, which has arrived today. And I'm going to record a couple of videos, and in this video, I'm just going to show you how it works and how to use it. So let's dive right in. And you can already see on the right side in the properties panel, there is a section about generating vector graphics. But it's also available in its own panel. And since the properties panel also has a couple of other functionality, let's open the dedicated panel. So let's go to Window and then Text to Vector Graphics Beta. So there it is. And you see there are several options, so let's just dive right in. And we have the choice of type we want to create. So there's subject, scene, icon, and pattern. And these are the things we can create. And let's start with a scene. And you see the things changed a little. And the first thing that's notable is if you want to create this in a specific size and a specific proportion, then take the rectangle tool and drag a rectangle in the size you want to create. So let's make it like this. And then this needs to be selected, of course. And then you can start off with sample prompts that are down here, or if they are hidden by some options you have already created, then you can go there by clicking on that light bulb icon. So we can just start with the sample prompts and maybe use this one here for the scene that we want to create. And you see, then you get some alerts, and there are about 10 alerts that give you tips on how to use this function. So it creates, and you see there's already some sketchy version, and then it refines them. And there we have the result, and can, of course, click through these three options and see which one suits best. And then, of course, if you don't like it, you can click on Generate again and get different versions of that prompt. You can also click on the settings. So there we have a style picker. If you have existing art, then you can click on it using the style picker, and Illustrator tries to match that. We're going to use that later. And then, which is probably more important, you can click on the settings, and there we've got a slider to adjust the detail. And we have a lot of detail already for this scenery. So this is the highest setting for the detail that we can get here. What's also turned on, it's here, match the active artboard style. So there wasn't any active artboard style, so that's kind of, it doesn't matter for this try. So let's just deselect this so that we don't see the paths. And this would be the first scene that we have created. Now we can also start with our own. I'm going to select this and delete it, and maybe make one like this. And we can maybe make a mountain scene and have it in summer, and a lake, and then we have the Matterhorn, which is a famous Swiss mountain, which has a very distinctive shape, and we put it in the background. So like this, and let's generate our own prompt here, and let's see what Firefly generates for us. So, and you see it generates, and let's see what it comes up with. And there we get it. So we've got nice colors in here, actually. This one is nice. And actually, if you look it up in the Wikipedia, the shape of that mountain is quite accurate. So this is quite nice. And that lake actually exists. So this kind of matches the scene quite well. So with this one, we can also continue. And then let's continue here. And maybe let's put a rectangle here, because now we want to put some more details into that scene. And we can now continue and put a subject in there. And let's put into there. And now it's important to match the active artboard style. And let's put some people hiking and having a rest. And you see, I have put the rectangle in here, which defines the size of the people I want to have. And you do not need to tell Illustrator to replace something or delete something. Just put into it what you want to have. So let's generate and let's see what it comes up with and have some nice people in this scene. And again, it generates them and puts them in there. And you see here, this is more like an icon. This is maybe not what we want to have, but these people, they match. They are sitting inside the lake, which is not so nice, but we can move them to here. And there we would have people fitting into the scene. But again, we can generate some more people and see if they match better into that scene. So, like this. And you see, they are quite large because this time I haven't drawn a rectangle first, so they are larger, but that doesn't matter. It's a vector, it's scalable, and we can later match that into the scene. So let's get to the next one. I have here a scene that I have drawn, and we can match that as well. And I'm going to draw a rectangle in there as well. And in this scene, so again, match the active artboard style. And let's have a train line for tourists in here. And let's go with that. And again, Illustrator is generating, and let's hope it fits this scene as well. And you see, you can match existing artwork, and that is something where you are usually asked if you have the copyright to use this artwork style. And then let's take a look at it. And you see, these are the trains that Illustrator generated for this. And I have already created some that we can take a look at. And you see, these are trains that Illustrator generated for this. And they match the overall colors of this artwork. Let's take a look at icons. And let's just see this here, and I have some icons that are grouped in this version and that are single icons here. So let's select the icons. And for the icons, I want to have again icons for a train. And this time I want to pick up the style. So I can use the style picker and click on here. And you see, this is the group. And so I want Illustrator to use all of them. So let's now generate this, but not before we check out this. And you see the detail is set to less because, of course, with icons, we want to have fewer details. We want them reduced. So maybe we can check out reduced style and maybe we get better results like that. So let's generate this. And let's see what Illustrator creates here. And let's see whether that matches. So let's check them out. And you see up there, we have the icons, but I'm not quite certain if these really match. So let's check out if we can get better results when we select some. And again, I'm going to draw a square to get a certain size. And let's again pick up the style, but this time I'm going to pick one of these icons and then generate them. And for icons, of course, it would be important to also match the line thickness, and that's why it's really important to create that rectangle so you get the certain size. And you see, the icon itself gets a little smaller, so when doing this, you have to figure out how much of extra space Illustrator needs and draw the rectangle in that size. So check these out. They are not quite what we want, so maybe we can make some more detail and generate that again and see what we can get here. Like so. And these are colored. So let's again pick this up and see if we can get better ones. Let's see if Illustrator makes black and white ones when we really click that first, but we still get colored ones. So that's something where you need more exploration when using that. And then we have the patterns. And to do that, so let's draw some clothing that we want to have filled with a pattern. And let's select the pattern here and check out what Illustrator has to offer. So let's try out one of these and see what it comes up with. And these patterns that Illustrator creates actually work as patterns. So we're going to see in a minute. This is the prompt, bright lines and dots. And this time the match active artboard style is unchecked. Illustrator has done that automatically. And there we have the patterns. So let's check out this one. And you see when I click on that, it has been added to the swatches. And then you can also go to edit pattern and get into pattern editing mode. And you get the pattern options panel to edit this pattern and get into the details. So this is how text-to-vector graphics in Illustrator 2024 works and how you can use it for creating your artwork.